Hey guys, this is Scarlett, and I'm here to talk to you today about leveling versus power leveling. We all know you're going to level whether you like it or not, just by doing the stuff that you do every single day. Doing your visits, clearing off your island, doing quests, collecting from your buildings. But let's talk about power leveling. The only difference lies in what to run, what to chop, what to visit for, what to plant, what to collect. There are so many collections in the game that give you free XP. One of my favorites is the tool collection because all you have to do is ask. This is just like free water given to you, hands down, no work involved, just ask. Then there are collections that you actually have to go out and hunt for, and I'll get to those in just a tad bit. But let's talk about animals first, just because they start with A and I'm just being lazy and going down a list here. There are animals that'll give you meat, there are animals that'll give you eggs, there are animals that will give you straight XP. While you're doing other stuff, these cats, these dogs, these jaguars, these puppies are designed just to give you XP while you're doing other stuff. So run them, take advantage of them. Now, let's talk about trees. There are so many trees on the island. Clearing an island will give you 1 XP, whether you're collecting your fruit, trees, or whether you're just chopping off palm trees that you just don't like having on your island. But there are the trees that will give you more XP than others. So go and get these trees. I'm sure a lot of you guys know this, but there are a couple of you who have never really paid attention to this. In 6 hours on the cherry tree, you're gonna get 25 cherries, just food, then you're gonna get 7 XP for it. So that means every 6 hours, you're gonna get 7 XP per tree. So what's gonna give me the highest XP? Well, let me tell you, I'm sure we've all been to islands where people have grown forests upon forests of pomegranate trees. Yes, pomegranate trees do give you the most when you look at this list. They give you 30 XP every 18 hours. Me, personally, I would go with the cacao because the cacao tree, or if you like to call it cocoa, the cacao tree will give you 10 XP every 5 hours, which is, in turn, less time for the same amount of XP. And this way, you know you're going to be on in 5 hours. I don't know where I'm going to be in 18. I might probably be still sleeping because I love to sleep. So I would personally go to the cacao trees. If you have them open, if you have all, if you have Wolf Island open, go for the olive trees. Those will give you 17 XP every 7 hours. Go for the grapefruits. Those are 10 XP every 6 hours. If you are overambitious, go for the avocado trees. Those are 17 XP every 4.5 hours. Go for the pandanus trees. My personal favorite, if you have it, do the coffee tree. The coffee tree is amazing. Every 2.5 hours, you're getting 17 XP. Yes, it's a little more on resources, but we're just talking about power leveling right now. We will go into what trees give you the best amount of food for the lowest amount of deposit. Whatever word I'm looking for, fill in the blank. We'll go into the fastest food trees. We'll go into the fastest growing trees. We'll go into, but right now we're just talking about the highest XP trees. So if you want to just go for the highest XP, if you're on Wolf Island, go for olive. If you're on Icy Rock, do the tangerines, do the coffee, do the cacao, do the pomegranates. You have so many options, and this is just per tree. So make sure you remember that it's per tree. And this is on your island, not while you're visiting somebody else's pomegranate are you going to get this. This is on your island only. So speaking of other stuff you could plant, let's talk about the plants. I'm sure you've come across islands that have had fields of carrots. Why are these people planting all these carrots? Because carrots do give you so much XP. Carrots will give you 14 XP per plant every 5 hours. If you have unlimited resources, go for the peppers. If you're going for the nearest thing and you're just a butt hair away, go for peppers. Every 9 minutes, you're getting 9 XP per plant. I will say there's a very notable mention here, and that's cucumbers, which I think are absolutely brilliant because you're getting 21 XP every 3 hours without the investment that you've put into peppers and without having to sit there and babysit them every 10 minutes. Kind of like running your buildings. Yes, I can get more XP for running my clay pits every 5 minutes, but I don't want to have to run to my island every 5 minutes, if that makes any sense. Then let's talk about the stuff that you chop. There's the trees that you could chop, there's the stones, there's limestone. Yes, you're going to get more XP per limestone, but you're using more energy. I like visiting, and I'm going to be talking a lot about visiting, but when you visit, you'll get a lot of purples, as you could tell I'm a hoarder, because I love to trade things. So like when I trade a bottle, when I click on this bottle, it'll say that I've received 1 XP, but when you look at your XP bar, you'll notice that you actually got 4 XP for it. That's just one gift that cost me 20 purples that I got just sleeping anyway. Let's do the bombs. Bombs will give you double. When you're chopping your swamps, you'll get double. A lot of the dark gifts will give you double XP. So focus on those when you're trading stuff, because everything you get out of a gift, you're eventually going to use. Whether you need it today or whether you'll need it down the line, you will eventually use it. Now, let's go back to visiting, because this is one of my favorite pastimes. A visit should not take you more than 30 seconds. So if I go to this person's island, I'm just going to a random person here. I mean, if it's your island, hey, hi. But I try to stick to the same island over and over and over, because that way I'm not spending 10 minutes loading a new island to get to. So I'm here, I'll click on something, I'll get my 5 XP, and I'll walk away. Yes, 5 XP per visit. Doesn't really mean much, does it? But if you consider that it only takes you about 30 seconds per visit, you're getting about 120 visits per hour times 5, plus whatever collections pieces you are picking up during this, you are getting a lot of XP. What are the best collections to go for? Well, we talked about the tool collection, which takes absolutely no effort whatsoever. Ask for that. If you want to go visiting for a collection that's going to give you the most, then we're talking about the kitchen collection. That is 40 XP per collection. Sometimes you'll get two pieces. That's an extra 80 XP. Times the 120 visits that you're doing in that hour, you're getting about, 10,000 plus XP in that hour. I do about 3 to 4, sometimes 5 hours of visiting while I'm letting my other buildings run or while I'm waiting for plants to be ready to harvest and do all that, but I'm building XP while I'm making XP. Like, if I want to power level, if I want to speed up, I am running buildings, I am planting, I am doing my trees, I am visiting and turning in those collections. Other collections, I mean, there are collections that'll give you 5 XP. I will talk to you more about those food collections and the food trees and the food, because everybody needs food. And then we'll probably make another video on water. I just wanted this one to focus on leveling, power leveling, what to focus on. Make sure that you take a look at what you need the most, go for that collection. I personally like the kitchen collection when I'm just going for XP, because not only is it the 40 XP per collection, I'm getting the free trees, which are going to give me XP when I harvest, which are also going to give me extra XP when I chop them. Plus it's free food and it's free mango pies and it's wonderful all in itself. I will probably, if really, 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 really requested, beg someone to let me use a very novice account, like my sister, because she doesn't play at all but knows that I do. So I will ask her to allow me to go live on her account and go from level 1 to level 10 in under 10 minutes, just to show you guys how easy it could be to get that XP. I understand when you're level 100 you need a lot more XP, but knowing what to chop, knowing what to visit, knowing what to collect, knowing what to grow, all these things will add up quick. We're nickel and diming, but we're trying to get the most bang for our buck. So with that, I say good night.